card features the 2016 celebration stamp set from Stampin' Up! Called Honeycomb Happiness. I'm going to go ahead and use this little bird. But before I start stamping with him, I've taken a piece of elegant eggplant and a piece of So Saffron, and I've run them through my Big Shot using my honeycomb embossing folder. So I've put some adhesive behind this strip, and now I'm just going to put this on the bottom of the front of my card. Just like that. Next, I'm taking some baker's twine. I'm going to wrap that around and tie a bow. One of the things I like to do when I'm doing up a bow is I like to take a glue dot and put it where I'm going to put that bow, so that when I tie it, it's easier because it will stay in place for me as if I have a third finger. Just push that down. This is just some baker's twine I had left over from a kit. It actually looks like it's maybe a gray baker's twine. You could use any color that you have. I'm just going to snip those ends off. So here are some scrap pieces of cardstock left over from some previous project. It's a piece of Watermelon Wonder and a piece of Whisper White. And I want to start using up my scraps. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to turn this into a little banner. Cut my V to one of the ends. I'm using my two-way glue pen. So here's a piece of Whisper White, and I'm going to do exactly the same thing. I'm just going to cut my little V into the end, make a little banner. And I'm going to put a little adhesive on the Watermelon Wonder. And stick that on top. This is just a fun way to give the card a bit more color and also use up those scraps. That's why it's so hard to throw away all these little tiny pieces of paper, because you can always find uses for them. So now we're going to do the focal point of this piece. This Whisper White measures 3 by 2.5, and I'm inking up my stamp using my Black Stays On. Stamp my little bird right in the center. Oops, I got a little mark there, so I'm just going to flip that over and stamp again. And I should say, when I'm stamping, I'm leaving a little bit down here because that's where I'm going to put my sentiment. So to color my bird, I'm taking my So Saffron ink pad, squeezing it so I've got a good puddle of ink in the lid. And I'm taking my Aqua Painter, and I'm just going to color him in. This is a really cute image that you can use for so many things. And because I stamped and stays on, the ink won't bleed. It's a very quick image to color. I'm taking my Pumpkin Pie to color in his little beak. So now that the first layer of color has dried, I'm going back into my So Saffron again, and I'm adding some more colors so that I've got some shading. And I am not one of these experts that knows where to put all the shadows and everything else, but I just do my best and it still comes out cute. So that's what I suggest you do too. Just have fun. That's the whole point of stamping, is having some fun. For the little chick's legs, I'm going to use my crumb cake marker. And I want it to look like my chick is actually standing on something. So to give it a little bit of grounding, I'm going to take my gray, actually my smoky slate, and again using my Aqua Painter, pick up some of that color and just lightly go underneath my bird. So now it looks like my bird has got some ground to stand on. So this is something else I like to do when I've got little images like this. I like to take a soft blue or even a soft gray and take my Aqua Painter, you could use a blender pen too, and I just go on the outside of that image, because what I find is it's almost like adding a bit of a shadow and kind of gives it some dimension. Only a little light wash. It's always better to add a little color, because of course you can go back in with more color later, but you can't take away the color once you have it on there. Hopefully you can see that in the camera, how that blue outline just gives him a little bit of a kind of like a dimension look. I'm going to stamp my Oh Hello from the same set with the stays on. And I'm going to use my Stampin'Majig because I want to make sure I get this in the right spot. So as you can tell, I still have other images on here. I don't always clean it after each use. And take my bird, position my Oh Hello right underneath him. Make sure it's straight. Put my handle. I love my Stampin'Majig. I honestly think it's one of the most important tools for stamping. There. Now I have my Oh Hello exactly where I want it. I'm going to take a couple of Stampin' Dimensionals, put them behind my bird. And just stick him right on top. So there's a really cute card for you using the Honeycomb Happiness. Nothing fancy pantsy. Running the cardstock through the Bake Shop with the embossing folder is what I think really gives the card that extra wow factor. Just having that image really kind of pops everything out. And then, of course, such a cute little focal image. So I hope you enjoyed that. Thank you for watching and happy stamping.